Kansas State, they too have had success in the 90s. Four straight nine-win seasons, four consecutive bowl games. They have a new quarterback. Michael Bishop is his name. He's a tremendous athlete. He runs 4.5 in the 40, and legend has it, he can throw the football from one goal line to the next.
Yeah, I'm going to wait and see that one. But right now, he is 27-0 as a starting quarterback. He was 24-0 the last 2 years at Blinn Junior College. Right now, he's 3-0 here at Kansas State. His biggest problem, he's never played in front of a crowd like this. So we'll see how he reacts under the pressure tonight.
I'll tell you what, 27-0 in any league is pretty darn good. Jason Peter and the Huskers getting set. Third ranked Nebraska, number 17 Kansas State.
Executed by the great offensive line of Nebraska. Two tights for Kansas State in their offense. And a busted play to get going. Michael Bishop lost 4 yards. Turned around to hand it off. And Eric Hickson was already gone into the hole. And this was something they were very concerned about. Bishop, in 2 years of junior college football, if you add up all the crowds he played in front of, it might not come out into 70-plus thousand as they have tonight in Lincoln. But he has the ability to run with the football, and he can really throw it.
What the Kansas State coaches want him to do is make some big plays on some broken plays, which he didn't do that time.
Look out for quarterback draw here on second and 13 out of the gun. Here it comes, and he is tripped up. Cutting in, Grant Wistrom, the All-American from Webb City, Missouri. Here's the offensive line. Weiner has usually done well against Wistrom in past battles. Jaycox has played very, very well in the month of September for Kansas State. Eric Hickson, a solid running back. Goolsby is back after a foot injury at fullback. They need him as the lead blocker. But the problem is they haven't put it up that frequently this year. Their leading receiver, tight end Justin Swift, and this is a throwing down. Third down and 14. Here's the strike, first down midfield. That's not a bad way to begin for Michael Bishop. He got it to 83, Everett Burnett, who hung on just his third catch of the year.
And that'll be the biggest boost for his confidence tonight. On his first pass, he completed it. But he's got to learn tonight. He's going to probably pay the price after every time he throws a forward pass, because those guys in the red shirts want to knock him down as much as possible and really try to intimidate the junior college.
The black shirts, that's what they call the defense here at Nebraska. Defensive line on the right side, you will not find a better pair in college football, trust me, than Jason Peter and Grant Wistrom. All-Americans, both of them. The Mike linebacker in the middle is Jay Foreman, the son of Chuck Foreman, the outstanding running back in the 70s for the Minnesota Vikings. And the secondary, a little bit young, but Ralph Brown, a sophomore cornerback, probably will play in the NFL one day. He is that good.
And if you have a question mark about Nebraska, it's probably the secondary. They've given up a bunch of big plays this year in the passing game, and it's something they've worked very, very hard on these last 2 weeks during the bye.
Second down and 11. Here's the option. Bishop will turn it up. He lost the football. They're going to say he was down after picking up maybe a yard and a half. Peter in on the tackle with Brian Shaw. Let's go downstairs on a very loud field to Greg Bell. Greg.
Well, I spoke with Ron Hudson before the game started, guys, and one of the things he was concerned with all the JUCO transfer guys he's got and the young players he's got starting today, he didn't want them to be overwhelmed by this Nebraska 12th man. As we can see at times, they become extremely loud and wild.
And the offensive coordinator for Kansas State. Third down and 10. Bishop with Todd. He's got a complete. Burnett. He could go. He needs a block. Inside the 10, toward the end zone, out of bounds at the 1 yard line. What a play by Burnett. Sweeney saved the touchdown. And there is the strength of the arm of Michael Bishop. If that ball wasn't gunned in there, it's going to be knocked down.
No question about it. Sweeney getting his first start tonight at one of the cornerbacks is a real freshman. In other words, he's a true freshman. But that is a gun right there by Bishop. And one of the things you got to get out of your receivers is exactly what Burnett's doing here, is run after the catch. He gets 25 yards extra, Drew, after the catch.
Hicks in over the top. touchdown, Kansas State.
A guy by the name of Cordell Stewart. He used to play at the University of Colorado. Now he's Pittsburgh.
Stewart. He is a pretty fair player. Second down and 10. Pressure on the outside coming. And they dump it in the flat to Henson,
who cannot tonight, instead of allowing him to call it on the line of scrimmage.
Three-step drop. And it's knocked down. They're trying to get it to Burnett. Good coverage by Ralph Brown. That's not the guy you want to pick on.
No, Ralph Brown's a big-time player. In fact, he's the first freshman to start at the University of Nebraska since first true freshman since World War II. He had Bishop Amont in California, and he's just an outstanding player.
Stoops now with the success he's had as the defensive coordinator at Florida under Steve Spurrier. Brothers very close. They talk every day.
Well, they should. They
probably push the back on return. 10-yard penalty. Timeout.
They probably exchange films too. But he's a little volatile right there, and you know he's going to get after. But that's what you got to do to be a good defensive coordinator. You got to be part of the game and be enthusiastic.
Stay upstairs. I'm too animated to be on the sideline. Michael Bishop hands it off.
Very tempo of the game, and I think they're starting to settle into it right now. By the way, they're the third biggest team in the National Football League right now in the offensive line.
There's a quarterback draw. Bishop takes a lick. That's Brian Shaw, who blew him a kiss in the backfield. It'll be a loss of a couple. He showed that big offensive line. What conferences do Washington...
This is a quarterback counter here, a new play that they put in for Bishop. It's like the tailback counter, where two offensive linemen pull, the quarterback gets the ball out of the shotgun and runs the counter play. Ron Hudson, the great offensive coordinator from Kansas State, put that in to maximize his running abilities.
Big play here, third and three. Three-step drop, Bishop throwing. And it's knocked away, and it's intercepted by Warfield. He has the sideline. And he'll get it to the 16-yard line, the first turnover of the game. Ralph Brown had the coverage. The old tip drill, Artie.
The old tip drill. It's just bad luck. Here's number three, Eric Warfield. He comes up to help on the slant pattern. Ralph Brown knocks it away. The ball is up in the air. It's the old tip drill that all defensive backfield coaches use. The ball fell right into Warfield.
Numbers on Michael Bishop against Northern Illinois. Very good. Ohio, he was pulled, Artie, but it didn't hurt his confidence.
It didn't hurt his confidence. It probably woke him up a little bit.
First and 10. Bishop, and this one's high and away, trying to get it down the field to number 80, Darnell McDonald. Ralph Brown was in his hip pocket.
He had some big-time pressure that time by the front from Nebraska, and you're going to see the big offensive lineman, Ryan Young, number 76, push Kelsey passed him, but Kelsey does a great job of coming back into Bishop. And like we've talked about, they want to, the Kansas State defensive front, keep hitting Bishop legally as much as possible. Because if you keep getting hit as a quarterback, you don't want to throw too many passes down the field.
There's Foreman. Look at the play clock. The reason we're showing this is Kansas State wants to use as much of it as possible to shorten the game. Out and up, this is up for grabs, and it's in and out of the hands of Mike Brown, the Rover. It'll set up third down. He should not have thrown that ball. Michael Bishop did not see the over-the-top help from Mike Brown.
And that's one of the problems with the junior college quarterback. Sometimes in junior college, they just run around and throw the ball up the field. But he threw that ball to a Nebraska player. He didn't throw it to his own guy. He's got to make a smarter decision on things like that. And again, that was the biggest concern that the coaches from Kansas State had going into the game tonight.
Burnett to the top is the widest outside the slot. QB draw. That play ended in a hurry. Bishop ran into Eric Johnson. And Kansas State will have to punt it to the Huskers.
Well, talking to Charlie McBride yesterday, the defensive coordinator from Nebraska, he said, we expect Kansas State to run a lot of quarterback draws, a little bit of option. Their linebackers were ready for it.
And a quick punt by Garcia to a trio of Huskers. And this is Bobby Newcomb, who's a quarterback, a freshman. They're going to be cheering for number 12 for three more years because he is the heir apparent at quarterback. The player of the year in the state of New Mexico last year. Kansas State needs to respond offensively. They scored on their initial possession, and they go backwards there. Mike Rucker, 6'6 and 250 pounds, and he got in the kitchen of Eric Hickson. And he might have stolen a couple of appliances.
Well, he really did. And he said to us, Winstrom and Peter are two of the best players he's ever coached. In fact, Jason Peter is the best defensive tackle he's ever coached. That's really saying something.
Been some great ones here. Third and 12. Quarterback counter. Michael Bishop gets a few, not nearly enough. You talk about the success of the Nebraska program. I think it begins with the coaching staff and the continuity they have under Dr. Tom Osborne.
Well, if you add this all up, it equals 137 years of experience, including Tom Osborne, here at the University of Nebraska.
With his arm so far, and I don't know if he can throw it 100 yards, but he sure as heck can throw it 50, and on a bullet, too.
I'll tell you, the story goes that he threw the ball 93 yards messing around in practice one day, and I don't care if they're off by 20 yards. That's some kind of arm.
That's some kind of arm, and he's a baseball player, too. He's a third baseman and a catcher. I'll bet you he's gunned down a lot of guys at second base in his day.
And he was not available for spring practice. Last spring, he was at Independence Community College, so he's really had about a month in this offense.
Yeah, you can't miss spring practice if you're a quarterback and expect to play great.
27 seconds left. Hickson with the football. He's going to lose a bunch. Ralph Brown, the corner, coming up and supporting. And now it's fourth down. And Nebraska calls another timeout. D'Angelo Evans is fun. He's out of Wichita, Kansas. Great player, but he had abdominal surgery. Michael Bishop on the option tackle from behind. Jason Peter, number 55. Maybe the hardest worker in this program, and that's saying something.
Oh, big time. And we met his brother yesterday, and his older brother, Christian, plays for the New York Giants, and that's quite a family. But he's a guy, along with his buddy, Wistrom, who are, by the way, roommates, have the best motors, maybe, in all of college football. The intense which they play on.
Well, who gets the list to go grocery shopping in that family? Bad pitch. Hickson's got a jump on it. He'll lose a bunch. Wrapped up by Brian Shaw. Chad Kelsey put the pressure on Bishop, and Kansas State's going backwards.
You know, if you're Kansas State, you got to think that Nebraska knows how to defend the option. Bishop comes on the corner that time, but I don't think he makes a very good pitch. It goes right over the top of Hickson's head. And Hickson's got a fall on that football, and then I punt.
Tough to hear in this end zone, and movement. Todd Weiner came out of his stance. Grant Wistrom, Eric Johnson pointing at his diagrams that have come in here and learned that.
Yeah, that's someone's an offensive defensive lineman from Nebraska.
Pressure coming, Bishop. Oh, boy, he pays for it at the six-yard line. Jason Peter, blew him a kiss. Jay Foreman also in the backfield applying pressure. The black shirts hold, and Kansas State will punt the football.
Somehow, I think,
2 weeks ago. 11:19 to go in the third quarter. Bishop goes play action. He runs it, and it's dropped. And that has been the story too frequently for Kansas State's wideouts this year. Gavin Parise had it in his hands. That was on a line for 45 yards.
Yeah, it's amazing. I mean, they have had nothing but problems.
Look at this, an option that goes back the other way. Hits and loses a bunch. Jason Peter was not fooled.
This guy is 285 pounds, and he has 9% body fat.
And you know, it's a killer. That just says what a big play that drop was the play before, because now instead of being down the field, it's minus yards, a little razzle-dazzle here. They're going to start an option to one side, but come back on like a reverse option. I'm not sure I've ever seen that before, but give all the credit to Peter. What a nice job of coming up the field and making the play.
Coach, I'm not sure you'll see it again.
I don't think so, nor do I want to.
3rd and 19. Bishop trying to get it to Paris, and there was good coverage, and the pass wasn't close. 4th down again for Kansas State.
It was a great tribute to his dad, and this young man, Jay Foreman, has got outstanding football intelligence.
That's what the coaching staff says about him. He's consistent, he's very bright. Michael Bishop needs to make some plays, and on the option, he turned the wrong way. And now he's running for his life. Oh, good block there on Johnson. And that is a spectacular 3-yard gain, folks. Eric Hickson nearly knocked Eric Johnson into the Nebraska sideline.
But that's what you get out of a guy like that. He might make the big mistake, he might make the big play, and he might make the crazy play. He runs literally 40 yards here, gets some great blocks, but as you said, only gets a 3-yard gain out of it. That's big time stuff right there. It's also exciting.
He ran 50 to get 3. They rush 5, time, and a completion.
And he really releases that football. He reminds me of a lot of great quarterbacks in the NFL that have got that baseball arm, Drew, that can really gun it. And maybe he can throw the ball 100 yards. Maybe you're right.
I'm telling you, he has a howitzer. We were watching him warm up. And remember that throw a couple of moments ago, 45 yards on a line. Hickson trying to get to the corner, running downhill. You can't outrun the Nebraska defense.
Two pretty good players. It's all coaching.
Yeah, I know. And the pass wide of Darnell McDonald on 3rd.
Watch this big guy right there, Eric Anderson. He comes around. He's an All-American player. He's going to end up blocking 2 guys. And Green just takes it on into the end zone. But that play was made by Eric Anderson.
In the state championship in Nebraska, this guy won the shot put. In 2nd place was the 305-pound kid, Anderson. How about that?
Speechless.
Bishop, all kinds of time, a rope, and a great catch inside the 30 by Darnell McDonald. Just his 2nd catch of the year. I'm amazed at his arm.
You know, he really did a good job, but you know, there was no one in the passing lane. The Kansas State offensive line's doing a good job of keeping these red shirts away from him. When he's got time, he is an accurate passer. And like you said, he throws that ball on a rope. But you know, the Nebraska defenders have got to go up and try to react to the football. They can't stand around and watch.
42-yard gain. They fake the toss sweep. Bishop on the slant. And Darnell McDonald pounded by Jerome Peterson. If we lose, it's not the end of the season. There's still plenty more football. Bishop has a man wide open. And Mike Lawrence catches it, but it's with the feet. So even if he gets beat up here tonight, he can still have a great season. 4th down and 3. Kansas State going for it. Nebraska comes with a blitz up the middle. Bishop in trouble. How do you get out of there? 1st down, Kansas State. That is what he brings to the table. Unbelievable athleticism. They had him dead to right, 6 yards deep in the backfield.
Great escapability. And one of the tough things when you're blitzing, if you come clean when no one blocks you, you got to slow down a little bit. If you don't, big guys like Bishop can avoid you. And that's exactly what happened to Jay Foreman that time. He had a clean shot at Bishop.
Counter Trey. Hickson explodes through the hole to the end zone. Touchdown. Last year in the Big 12 running it. They've had success, but against MAC teams tonight, not a lot of success.
No question. The quarterback's ability from Nebraska to run the football has been the difference in this game tonight.
Bishop with time. Throwing the out route. And you want to talk about good coverage. Ralph Brown was more open than ever
for Shelton, Nebraska. So you know that had to feel good for him.
And one of two Kansas State Wildcats from Nebraska. Bishop looks to the backside, nothing there. Now he's going to heave the bomb into double coverage. And, all right, now he let that go at the 40, and it landed at the goal line. So that was 60 yards, and the ball looked like about 12 yards off the ground. Do you think he can get it 93 now?
He might be able to. I still want to see him do it before I pass judgment, but he has got great arm strength. And if he can just control it, and if he can work within the confines of the offense, he might have a good future here. Obviously, tonight's going to be a disappointment for him. But what he's got to do, he's got to get better next week and a little bit better the week after because he hasn't played very much. This is only his fourth game.
That's right. His last loss, state semifinals in high school when Willis, Texas went down. Bishop on second and 10. Given time, there's a strike and through the hands of his intended target, Darnell McDonald, who took a lick.
Well, you don't want to hang your receiver up like that because if the ball's in the air over the middle, a defender is looking around, lurking around, looking to lay the wood onto you. And that's what happened that time. Let's just hope he just got the wind knocked out of him.
I know I sound like a broken record. We have a great view because we're up high. But that was another 40, 45-yard pass on a rope.
Yeah, it is. And like I said, he's a good baseball player. He's got a good arm.
And the thing that has to develop for Kansas State, not only Michael Bishop has to mature as a quarterback and get used to playing at this level, completely different level than the junior college ranks, already, as you've pointed out, but this receiving crew, very young. Kevin Lockett led them last
year. The ball is thrown high, but I tell you, it looks like McDonald just gets the wind knocked out of him the way he came down. But if he would have been in a little bit more of an inside position, he could have really gotten knocked out. And it was a good job by the Nebraska defenders, especially Harrison, number two, going up for the ball.
Georgia, his hometown. Nebraska sends five, turn in, good strike, and it is complete. Old school to beat Nebraska.
All right.
Nope. Here's Bishop on a QB draw. Breaks a tackle. Bishop to the 15. He's a lot of fun. He can make plays. Knocked down by Brandon Harrison.
Boy, is he one heck of an athlete. The coaches were right about that. And, you know, you asked me, why did they recruit him? Because he's not a polished quarterback. Well, that's why they recruited him, because they saw sparks of greatness with this guy when he makes some things happen and his escapability. But now you got to somehow, like we talked about.
Third and 10 for Bishop. Pressure. Scramble time. Look at this. 10 to the 5. To the 4.
Ball carried by Michael Bishop.
Rucker finally there defensively along with a few other red jerseys. Michael Bishop, he can go 1 on 11 and make people miss.
Well, you know, he kind of ignores the first guy who's around him. He always does that. Look at him. He just ignores him. His eyes are down the field looking for the second guy. He is a big-time threat when he's got that ball in his hands. And I'll tell you, if I was choosing up sides for a street game, I would take this guy on my team.
He'd be number one.
He would be number one in my draft.
First and goal at the 4. Bishop will walk in. Touchdown, Kansas State. That was a Michael Bishop drive, almost exclusively.
Almost exclusively all Michael Bishop. And, you know, again, it seems like he's settled down. Obviously, the game is a little bit out of reach. Does a good job of faking into the line here. But there was no question in his mind that he was looking into the corner.
By 4 touchdowns, Kansas State. Bishop still at quarterback. Throwing it down the middle. That's intercepted downfield. The football is Walker. Joe Walker, one block, and he could get in. Oh, baby, what a return that was. 71 yards for Walker.
Put him at tailback.
Freshman from Arlington, Texas, the third team Rover.
Boy, Michael Bishop, he really takes a beating. Gets knocked down once, gets held, going to try to make the tackle, falls down. Boy, that's a tough throw, and it's a tough play after the throw for poor Michael Bishop.
The left-footed Ted Retzlaff, the senior, and this one is botched. And Frankie London will scramble to the turf. So the one-point conversion is no good. 54-20 the score. Let's go downstairs now with the New York Giants. He, Rob, and his other brother Steve, all high school valedictorians. How about that for a family? Bishop goes down. He was sacked. Brandon Drum was in there.
You know, I'm surprised here now that Kansas State is trying to throw the ball too much, but that last scoring drive was very impressive by Michael Bishop. 84 yards, he had 32 rushing, 18 yards passing. Let him run the ball a little bit more and get this offense.
And whistles come in. And there was still time on the play clock.
Dead ball, false start offense. 5-yard penalty, half the distance. Third down.
Right now, Kansas State would like to pack their bags and get back on the bus. Here's an interesting fact. You know, playing in the junior college ranks, you bus wherever you play, especially in the Jayhawk League. He's only been on one flight as a college football player. That was the opener to Northern Illinois because they bussed last night from Manhattan. It's only about a 2.5-hour drive. Give you an idea of the inexperience for this club. Ball's on the ground. Did Kansas State get it back? It'll either be 2 points or 6 points.
A fumble on the play.
2 points.
It looked like Bishop hit the hip of the back when he was handing it off. Again, he's an excited young man here. Sometimes he does things too fast. He hits Hickson's elbow. He hits the elbow. The ball was handed off too high. And those are the little things that he missed during spring ball. The handoff skill, the footwork on running plays. Very, very little things that make you a good quarterback or an average quarterback. And obviously, you looked average on that one, but those are the little things that experience will give this young man in terms of making him a complete quarterback. And obviously, he's not very happy about it.
I'll tell you what, Carlos Polk, even if the exchange was made, may have produced a safety on the play because he was already in the backfield ready to wrap up Hickson.
Yeah, they got some great penetration on that. And you've seen some backup players now for Nebraska that are going to go in there and they want to prove their worth and say, hey, I deserve my scholarship and someday I want to be part of that starting unit here at Nebraska, especially on defense, the black shirt. So you're going to get guys, even though they're second teamers, Drew, really playing hard in the final 3 or 4 minutes of the game.
27-0 in his college career coming in. It'll be 27-1, and though he's disappointed, 27-1 is a pretty good record. And if you look at Kansas State and the schedule they have the rest of the way, they're at home the next couple of weeks, Missouri, Texas A&M, come a calling. Two pretty good football teams.
Nebraska, and they absolutely love him. I'll bet you he ends up starting before the year's over for Kansas State.
Bishop will tuck it up again toward the sideline. And Michael runs out of bounds after an advance of about 6 yards. He's still going strong. There's Mike Stoops on the right. 56-20, Nebraska with 1:12 to go.
You know, he's not going to be a happy guy, but he's got to take the positives of tonight and build on them. He's an emotional young coach, obviously comes from some great bloodlines in the coaching profession, but he will get this Kansas State defense playing exactly the way he wants it before the year.
Kansas State with 9 football games again. Bishop, end zone shot, has a man. Touchdown, Darnell McDonald. There's no quit, number 7. Tom Osborne will meet his longtime friend, Bill Snyder, at midfield.
And for the second time in a row now, first the Washington Huskies, and now the Kansas State Wildcats, I think Nebraska has proven that they are a team that is on the ascend this year and are going to be competitors for the national championship when the season is over.
I know the Washington Huskies know that. I think Bill Snyder and the Wildcats realize that tonight.